are smack in the middle of the holiday season, so tonight on Animal Island, tips on keeping your pet comfy and safe through Christmas and New Year's. Joining me now here in the studio, the pet lady, Dana Humphrey. Welcome, Dana.
Hi, thank
Dana
you.
Dana travels around the country scouting out the hottest products at pet trade shows and consumer events because the statistics show so many of us buy holiday presents and Christmas presents for our pets.
They sure do.
Because they're part of the family. And she is here with our special guest, Tinkerbell, who happens to be a model who was discovered by Ralph Lauren. First, Dana, tell me that story.
Well, this is Tinkerbell. She is a star, but she actually, her roots are from the little shelter here in Long Island.
Yes.
Yeah, so she's a rescue gone runway, and she's an amazing dog. She is on Instagram. She's a star. She does tons of modeling. You can find her at tinkerbelltheDog.com.
She has her own card.
She has
and she's
her
own on sticker. Every she's her, she has every social media platform that you can think of. Tinkerbell is there.
And so let's welcome, talk about what Tinkerbell is wearing.
Yeah, okay, let's talk
she's
about
wearing
that.
She's wearing her holiday plaid from Gold Posse series, and of course her little, you know, bling-a-bling bow tie to get ready for the season.
Yeah, because you have to dress up for the holidays as well. All right, let's talk about the safety too, because we're going to quickly talk about some of the products, but some safety tips. So number one, if you have a Christmas tree, make sure it's secure. Right?
Make sure it's secure. You know, cats like to jump on things and topple things over. Also, avoid a Douglas fir. It's a particular type of Christmas tree that is extremely poisonous to dogs.
Oh, didn't know that.
If they eat the branches or eat the pine needles, they actually are going to develop this slime going on. It's very toxic to them, so you want to avoid that type
and
of tree.
And that's the same issue for mistletoe and holly as well?
And poinsettias.
Okay, and that I've heard of, but I didn't know the mistletoe
every dog
and holly.
Is different, so you know how they are if they really get into things.
Right.
Just keep it out of reach,
okay.
Especially don't leave them home with it.
All right, and do without the tinsel, especially if you have cats, because that's guaranteed they're going to jump on your tree,
bows,
right?
Tinsels, candles, you know, all things that are big no-nos if you're having a holiday party and your pets are around.
Right.
Something else that's really important during the winter is paw care.
Okay, right.
So one option is to put your dog in little booties.
If they'll keep them on, because my dogs will not walk if they have booties on their feet.
And another one is this achy paw mat. It's awesome. It actually is eco-friendly, and it heats their paws as they lay on it. So it makes them feel good, like a little heating blanket, but it's completely safe.
And I know I use pet-safe snow melt in order to make sure that it doesn't stay on their pads.
If we get any snow, that's a great
Well, okay,
plan.
January, February, and March. And also when it comes to you know, your ornaments and things, keep the wires, the batteries, and all the ornaments out of the reach of your pet, because that's important also.
I like this ornament because it's made with wood, so that's a great option.
And you can put your pet's name on it too, right?
Yes, and you know, a lot of times during the holidays, there's a lot of noises, especially during New Year's, or there's fireworks, or it's uncommon noises.
And a lot of unfamiliar people, right?
So you can always create a little zen zone for your dog or cat. You know, maybe put a movie on, make a safe carrier space for them. Your dog's favorite smell is you.
Right.
So take an old t-shirt, an old scarf that smells like you, and give it to them. They can, like, cuddle up with it. If they're very scared, you can always give them a calming coat or, you know, give them some lavender or some, you know, essential oils.
Look at that. So all the stuff that calms us calms them down as well.
Yes, exactly.
And don't forget, you know, the treats for their stockings and stuff like that.
Smart bones are a great option. It's a non-rawhide alternative.
Right.
And you know, no bones about it. Don't give your dog any chicken bones, any turkey bones. If Aunt Fran comes over for Christmas
Eve,
don't let them give your dog the bones.
Our time is out for now. Thank you so much. We have so much more information. Dana's got a lot. So if you want to follow Dana on Twitter, her account is @PetLadyWorld, and just search Tinkerbell and you'll definitely, Tinkerbell the dog, you'll find it. We also have a link to her website on news12.com.
And we have a special flag.
Oh my goodness.
Let it snow, personalized with Tinkerbell from Flagology.
Oh, that's perfect. So we'll be right back.
Little gift for
Thanks,
Santa
guys,
Claus.
For coming in. Tinkerbell, thank you.